Hello, hello! My name is Marcin Iwaniec from Dragon's Diamond, and welcome to this very special episode in our Neural Network NPC AI series. Why special? Because we at last can present something that is related to actual subject of Neural Network NPC AI, that is, Neural Network. This is the first video in three-part subseries about neural networking, and today we will talk about decision-making and online training. Next video will be about offline training, aka backpropagation. In first video, we will shortly cover self-learning process after finished training process. And that said, let's begin! Firstly, we have to draft something to make clear what we are talking about. What is neural network? Imagine a human brain that constantly processes some inputs from our senses. It can be sight, hearing, taste, smell, or touch. Our brain processes that inputs and draws some outputs. To simplify, let's say that outputs are muscles. In the very, very simplest term, our brain decides how the body should behave, basing on events happening around us. But how the brain itself works? Again, very simplifying, brain works thanks to neurons. Billions of neurons are connected with each other, where each connection has own weight, what finally makes a great mathematical network. It's brilliantly simple and genius. We have some input represented by a value. That value is multiplied by weights, summed, and plotted to a connected neuron. This process is repeated until our value reaches final output neuron. Of course, current technology cannot replicate complexity of human brain, but we can make simplified models targeted to certain tasks. This is exactly what is happening in Neural Network NPC AI. In this case, our task is to make seemingly simple decision. Do or not to do some actions basing on current situation. So, how did this looking in our case? Output is easy. It's one neuron that can have value negative or positive. We can assume that value close to zero is neutral, and neural network can decide if it should do action or not. Humans also often have problem to decide what to do. For example, what to eat, tasty pizza or healthy salad. It depends from a lot of factors, but let's try to simplify them. Humans, after all, are very egoistic beings. It's in our DNA, and it's relative to survival instinct. So, our personal attitude to certain action is very important. We can love to eat pizza much more than salad, no matter what. Okay, but we still have that voice in our head that tells us that pizza is not really healthy and we should eat salad. It's called conscience. In case of pizza, value will be negative, since our conscience is screaming, "Do not eat that pizza, fatty!" We have to also consider action importance. If we are hungry, it does not matter if it's salad or pizza, as long as it's food. It's just important to eat. Let's assume that we are hungry, so the action importance is very high. Last thing is our skill in certain action. It might not be most important parameter in case of eating, but still, we would have hard time to eat rough chicken without knowing how to prepare it. But for the sake of this example, let's say that skill parameter is zero. So, what output will be here? We will eat that pizza? That is an excellent question. Every person can come to other conclusion. It depends from the weights. That can be different for every person, and that is what makes neural network so special. It individualizes NPCs to be a unique entity. But how to form those weights? It's easy. The same way children are learning. With teacher help or by own experience. First technique is basing on pattern values. Basically, we are expecting output value to be same as we wish. So, neural network's task is to try to form weights as long as the output gets close to the pattern. But we'll discuss that in next video. Second technique is based on real-time learning, where our network decides something, and after a while, NPC can experience consequences of its actions. Those can be good consequences, and then weights are strengthened, but those can also be bad consequences, and NPC have to try something else to achieve its goals. This technique is close to real life, since often we don't have chance to check if our actions are leading us in good direction until life strikes us with consequences. Okay, that's the theory. Of course, there is a lot more to it, but it's enough to understand how neural networks are working. Now, let's see online learning in practice. What we are seeing there is two groups of tic-tacs. Color ones are the learning ones. It is very important that during training process, learning individuals do not interact with each other. At least not until their weights make any sense when decisions are making. So to allow them fight or pickpocketing, the world is filled with the gray tic-tacs. Their experience is not considered, so we can make with them whatever we want. And it will not affect training process. But they still have very important functionality. They inherit yet best discovered weights composition. What that means is they always have neural networks same as the actual smartest individual, and thanks to that, we can see in what direction the training is going. For example, no decision made by a tic-tac make no sense. They are running back and forth or trying to sleep when they are fully rested. But after 24 hours of intense training, well, now their action make much more sense. No one is running without sense, they react reasonable. We can check the best neural network in our neural network debug tool. Let's see how output is affected by inputs. Completely positive inputs give us output value 1. Completely negative inputs give us output value around minus 1.4. It makes sense. Negative parameters make tic-tac to resign from action, but positive attract it. What about adding positive parameters one by one? We can see that output is increasing, but parameters are not treated equally. For example, attitude parameter is almost ignored, but means that attitude is not much effective in making money in this world, or simple training was too short and tic-tac did not realize yet that considering attitude helps them make better choices. We have made 1000 hours of testing to make sure that this mechanism is working. We can see now two final results of online training on the charts. One represents the worst result, and second one the best. Y-axis represent money, that is amount of gold that tic-tac earned. X-axis represent epoch number. Each epoch consists of 5-day work week, where individuals try to make the largest amount of money. We can see that at the beginning of the training, tic-tacs didn't know what to do to earn money, but from time to time, some individuals have found its way to get rich. This can be observed on the red line. After each new best result, average score, gray line, increased. On both charts, we can see that the results are very close to each other, but still, there is a difference. From where it comes? Pure luck. Well, that's it for today. We are very proud for our neural network NPC AI, but we have still a lot of work. Expect next video, where we cover situation when online test is not possible and we have to teach our NPC straight from the data table, where we have write down what, where and when. Thank you for staying to the end and stay tuned!